So, can anyone learn to sing? I think so. And if you're wondering if you can sing, I think you've come to the right place. Hey guys, thanks for joining me. My name is Keith Harris. This is Keith's Keys. Today's topic, can anyone learn to sing? And the answer is yes, I think so. But let's talk about singing first. Why is singing so special? I think of all the different talents and hobbies that are out there in the world, singing seems to be the most attractive. And why is that? Why does everyone want to sing? Is it because of the money? Is it because of the fame? Is it because they want to perform everywhere? I actually think it's because of how music makes us feel. Maybe you do want to sing like a famous person who's really excited you, but you want to sing like that person because there's a particular song or a sound of their voice that really moves you, and you want to do that as well. Singing is the sound, I mean the voice, the voice itself is the expression of the human condition. And singing is a very powerful way to experience that. It's fun. It feels good. It's fun to sing with other people. It's exciting. Some want to challenge themselves to perform in front of a crowd. But I think the short thing is, singing just feels good, and it's going to make you live longer. I think it's really healthy for people. I've noticed that people that I've met in choral societies that have sung their whole life seem to be happier and living longer than those who don't sing. So just plain and simple, singing is good for you. Diet and exercise, great. Singing, even better. So let's get into, all right, can anybody learn how to sing? And the answer is yes. The very first and most important thing to singing is to sing with your own voice. Don't try to sound like somebody else. You are a unique person, and every single voice is as individual as a fingerprint. When you listen to the radio, you're going to hear something that's been fully processed, has been auto-tuned, has been chopped up, has been rehearsed over and over. And even if you heard that artist live in person sitting in your living room, it would not sound like that recording you hear on the radio. So don't try to mimic that, all right? Even the person who recorded it doesn't sound like that. So honor your own voice. Sing with your own voice. Secondly, when you're singing with your own voice, don't stretch yourself into areas that strain or make you go hoarse. You know, we can learn to sing better. We can learn to sing with a wider range, but there are going to be limits. And if you push yourself into areas that you don't belong, you could really strain and hurt your voice. So be honest to your own voice and no strain. Next is to practice your flexibility and agility every single day, right? Coordination, muscle memory, coordination of the muscles in the body are what helps singers get a lot better. And to do this, I really recommend a voice teacher, an expert who can really help you learn how the bits and pieces work, right? So if you wanted to become a golf expert, you really wanted to learn to play golf, you wouldn't just pick up a club and start swinging. I mean, maybe you would, but I highly doubt you'd become, you know, a professional athlete doing that. You would need a coach to teach you how to hold the club, how to swing the club, how to make the golf ball go where you wanted it to, and singing's the same way. Only we're more afraid to find a teacher because singing is so personal. We don't want to let somebody in there. But think of it like going to the gym, right? You want to get a six-pack, so you go to the gym and you do exercises to build those muscles. This is a muscle as well. So you go to a teacher who is like going to your trainer at the gym, who will give you exercises to make that muscle better and better. And one of the really important places is in your breath. Why? What's with the breath? Isn't this the singing voice? Well, yes, but this is a wind instrument. So the better we get with the wind, the more that all of this tension can fade away. And there's a lot of things we can do to increase our lung capacity, to increase our coordination. If you were getting ready to run a marathon, your legs have to get stronger. But when you first start running, what's the problem? If you've never run before, right, you're running out of air. You can't get your breath under you. You say, my legs feel pretty good. I can't breathe. Singing is a lot the same way. You can increase the quality and the use of your breath, your lung capacity, and that all helps the use of the voice. And my third tip for learning how to sing, and this might be the most important of all three, is understanding there is no magic trick. There's no quick bullet. There's no one exercise in 2 minutes does all. There's no 30-second abs for the rest of your life. It takes the real magic bullet is hard work every single day. When you see artists, maybe you've just discovered a new singer on the radio. Say, oh my God, I've never heard of this person. Who is this? But the truth is, in order to get on the radio and do that, that person has been practicing every single day, years and years and years, playing in clubs, playing in pubs, playing all over, perfecting their skills. So by the time you saw them for the first time, you said, whoa, what is this finished product? But there was a lot of work that went into it. Same thing if you go to the gym, you know? If you say, like I said earlier, you want six-pack abs, you're not gonna go to the gym once or once a month or twice a year. It takes regular work every single day. So the magic bullet is regular work. And I recommend regular work with a voice teacher because that way you're getting really specific, good work. Quality practicing in smaller chunks is so much better than just a lot of practicing and hoping for the best. Again, are you going to take a golf club and just swing at it? Or are you going to work with a coach and make sure that even if you only swing 3 times, it's the perfect swing? Same thing with singing. That coordination is just as important. In the end, I think that the singing voice is uniquely human. It is the only instrument that uses text and uses the full strength of the human body to make music. And that is so special. So understand that you are unique, your voice is special, and enjoy singing. Thanks for joining me.